While you're on the waiting list, UNOS, the private, nonprofit organization that manages the nation's organ transplant system, is constantly identifying potential donors. As soon as a potential organ is located, a local organ procurement agency is notified. The organ procurement agency has professionals trained in discussing organ donation with families and their loved ones. These professionals, called procurement coordinators, work in hospitals to ensure organs are in good condition for donation. When the time comes, there are two types of donor organs you may be offered, either a standard donor or an extended criteria donor. A standard donor is a healthy person who has suffered brain death. Approximately one-third of donors are considered standard donors. An extended criteria donor can be either someone who is age 60 or older, or someone who is age 50 or older but has certain medical conditions, such as hypertension, decreased kidney function, or stroke. Accepting an offer of an extended criteria donor may decrease your waiting time for a transplant. Also know, we may offer you an extended criteria donor if we feel your risk of death while waiting for a transplant is greater than the risk of receiving an extended criteria donor. We want you to know that there are potential risk factors related to having a transplant. Every transplanted donor organ can transmit cancer, allergies, or an infection. The risk is very small, but it is not zero. Despite rigorous screening and questionnaires, diseases such as HIV, hepatitis B, or hepatitis C can be transmitted during a transplant. Donor-related factors that could affect the success of your transplant surgery include, but are not limited to, the medical and social history of the donor, the age of the donor, and the condition of the donated organ. Additional donor-related factors that could affect the success of your transplant surgery include viruses, such as cytomegalovirus and Epstein-Barr virus. A lot of people carry these viruses inside of them. These viruses are highly prevalent in the general population. We will consider accepting donors with these viruses to increase your donor pool. If we do accept such an organ, we will provide you with extensive screening, monitoring, preventive medications, and treatment. Because of the prevalence of these viruses in our population, there is a high chance the organ you receive will have one of these viruses. Cytomegalovirus is found in 40 to 60% of the general population. If you receive a donor infected with cytomegalovirus, the effects could be severe, especially in the first months after your transplant. Another donor-related factor that could affect the success of your transplant surgery is valley fever. Valley fever is widespread in the southwestern region of North America. Of course, additional laboratory tests will be done if we find out the donor organ may have been exposed to valley fever. Remember, even with all the extra testing we do, transmission of these viruses to you may still occur, but it is rare. We classify some donated organs as coming from Public Health Services donors. That means the donor organ came from a person identified as having an increased risk of certain viral diseases, such as HIV, hepatitis B, and hepatitis C. These organs undergo extremely sensitive and specific testing. These donated organs must demonstrate no evidence of virus before we will consider using them for you. Remember, even with the extra testing we do, transmission of these viruses to you may still occur, but it is rare. Transmission rate from these donors is less than 1%. These donors make up 25% of the nationwide donor pool. We want you to carefully consider that the risk of staying on the transplant waiting list is often greater than taking the risk of getting a disease from a PHS donor. We also want you to know that sometimes we get false positive lab results when we test donated organs. This means the organ does not contain the virus, but the test result mistakenly says it does. If you are not willing to consider a PHS donor, this will limit your access to donor offers. Remember, these donated organs make up 25% of the nationwide donor pool. We want you to know that just because a donated organ is classified as increased risk, this does not mean it is of poor quality. Whether you choose to accept or refuse an offer of an increased risk donor organ, the quality of the care you receive will not change. If you agree to an increased risk donor organ, we will have you sign an additional consent form. After transplant, you will need additional blood work for 1 year. You may need additional treatment if your blood work has positive results. Remember, all health information is kept strictly confidential, so we are not able to tell you why we consider the organ at increased risk and what activities the donor may have engaged in. If we determine that a donor organ is hepatitis B core antibody positive, we will only offer it to patients who also have prior exposure to hepatitis B. Remember, the donated liver is normal, but the blood work shows past exposure to hepatitis B. Patients who receive a hepatitis B core antibody positive liver will require additional protective medication for the rest of their lives. Sometimes we receive donated organs that are infected with hepatitis C. We will only offer this type of organ to patients who already have an active hepatitis C infection. Survival rates for this type of transplant are comparable to those of patients who receive non-hepatitis C organs. Many new treatments are now available for hepatitis C and may provide a cure post-transplant. We also receive organs from donors who have suffered devastating and irreversible brain injury and may be near death but do not meet formal brain death criteria. In these cases, the donor's family has decided to withdraw care. Occasionally, we receive a donor liver that we can split into two sections. That way, two people can receive a transplant from one donor liver. We often have family members ask us if they can donate a part of their liver to a recipient. Sometimes this is possible. The person who wants to donate a portion of their liver must be healthy, have a compatible blood type, and must undergo a thorough medical and psychological evaluation. The transplant team carefully weighs the risks and benefits of the donor against the probability of a successful outcome for the recipient. There are specific criteria to determine who is suited for a living donor surgery. Remember, it is a major surgery that carries medical and surgical risks. Please let us know if you would like more information regarding living liver donation, or if you have a family member or friends that would like to be assessed as possible donors.